Target 11 is watching how your tax dollars are spent, and tonight we're taking a look at a public pension plans.
And Peggy, we found some law enforcement officers who were accused and even convicted of misconduct, but still got to keep their benefits. Channel 11's Rick Earle followed the money trail to find out how this could happen. He's live with the results of his investigation now. Rick.
Yeah, David, we discovered just because you're a public employee convicted of a crime doesn't automatically mean you're going to lose your pension. In fact, as we found out, it really depends on what type of crime you're convicted of. Former Allegheny County Sheriff Pete DeFazio pleaded guilty to macing, or forcing employees to contribute to his campaign. But DeFazio didn't lose his $3,000 a month pension.
You think this is a guy who deserves his pension?
Yes, personally I do.
Marty Dietz represented DeFazio, who pleaded guilty to a lesser misdemeanor charge instead of risking a trial where a conviction could have stripped his pension.
He did a lot of good things for this county, and we wanted to make sure that he was able to still reap some of the benefits of that hard work.
DeFazio's Lieutenant Richard Stewart also pleaded guilty to misdemeanor macing, and he gets $4,100 a month. A jury convicted Captain Frank Shirali of lying to a federal grand jury. It's a felony, but he still gets $3,500 a month. And since 2005, the three have been paid more than $1 million in taxpayer-funded pensions.
When you commit a crime that is directly associated with your job and the powers you have, to me, that is, in a sense, going against the public trust, and you should lose your pension.
But under state law, public employees only lose their pension if convicted of certain crimes associated with their office, such as theft and forgery. Macing and lying to a federal grand jury are not on that list.
To me, that goes against certainly the intent and certainly the spirit of the public pension forfeiture law.
And neither is rape and murder. State Representative Daryl Metcalf says they should be. And he sponsored legislation prohibiting public employees convicted of felonies from collecting a pension.
We need to protect the taxpayers from being violated in this way by a criminal who's allowed to keep their pension after they've committed a crime against their neighbor or fellow citizens.
Now, we reached out to all three officers. Two responded but didn't want to go on camera. DeFazio still maintains he did nothing wrong. He says he just didn't have the money to fight the federal charges. And both he and Shirali tell me they're thankful they still receive their pensions, and they say they have now moved on from that part of their lives. That is the very latest reporting live downtown. Rick Earle, Channel 11 News.
Okay, Rick, thank you so much, and we're interested in your story ideas for Rick Earle. Email them to us at target11@wpxi.com. We're also on Facebook and Twitter.